This video is going to look at an example of dealing with vertical motion, and to do that we want to look at our position function. And our position function here is s of t equals negative 16 t squared plus v sub 0 times t plus s sub 0. So let's go through and identify what each of these variables represent. The first part here, s of t, this is your position. So here the function is actually identifying the position of some object or something traveling over some period of time. So here t is representing the amount of time, and v is the velocity of our object. And notice we have the little sub-zero, and the little sub-zero is indicating the initial, your beginning velocity. So this is the initial velocity. And you probably can guess here that if s is the position, s sub-zero would be your initial position. So here we can identify the position of our object that we're looking at traveling here based on t is time, our initial velocity v sub 0, and the initial position. So let's see if we can go through this example using our position function. The problem is we're given a ball that is thrown straight down from the top of a 220-foot building with an initial velocity of a negative 22 feet per second. And the reason this is negative is because this ball is throwing down, so that's kind of giving us the direction that the ball is traveling. So it's a negative 22 feet per second. And they want us to calculate what is the velocity after 3 seconds. So if we go over here and we look at our position formula, we plug in, we have s of t is equal to negative 16 times t. Well, that's what we're looking for. We're looking for the velocity after 3 seconds. So we know eventually here we're going to be using our time here. So that's negative 16 t squared plus our velocity. Well, our velocity, v sub 0, what is that? Well, v sub 0 is actually equal to the negative 22 feet per second. So that's when this ball is thrown. If we have a person here up here is throwing this ball straight down, the initial velocity is a negative 22 feet per second. So we would plug in the place of v sub 0, a negative 22 times t, plus s sub 0. Well, what is the initial position? Well, if you notice, they told us the ball is throwing straight down from the top of a building that is 220 feet tall. So that means our initial position then is going to be equal to the 220. So here we have our position function. So if we're given some time, we can locate the position or the location that this ball is located after a certain amount of time t. Now the question we're trying to calculate is, what is the velocity? If we're trying to calculate the velocity, we can actually find that by taking the derivative of our position function. So up here, for example, if we have our position function is s of t, this is your position function, and if we take the derivative s prime of t, that's going to give us v of t, which is going to be the velocity. So that's kind of a nice and quick shortcut to find our velocity function. So if we want to do that here, if we want to find s prime of t, that's going to give us v of t, the velocity. So if we do that, we need to take the derivative of our position function. So we're going to take 2 times negative 16, which is going to give us the negative 32 t, and then a derivative of negative 22 t would simply be a negative 22. And of course, the derivative of the constant 220 goes to 0. So this here is going to be our velocity function. So we have v of t equals negative 32 t minus 22. And the question asks, what is its velocity after 3 seconds? Well, we can simply plug the 3 in, so we get v of 3, and we would have negative 32 times 3 minus 22, and we come up with an answer of negative 118 feet per second. Okay. Now, what if I went a step further and I decided to ask the question? So this tells us that after 3 seconds has passed, so once we throw the ball, 3 seconds has passed, at the 3 second point, that ball is traveling at a negative 118 feet per second. And again, the negative is simply telling, indicating to us here that the ball is going in a downward path. So this has given us that instant rate of change. Okay, so this is the instantaneous rate of change at the point 3 seconds. So keep in mind, in the past, you've probably looked at the rate of change and we calculated what we would call the average velocity. But in this case, we're looking at the instantaneous rate of change. So that's the velocity at that exact 3 seconds. All right, let's say that I propose another question here. So we'll call this maybe part B to this problem. What is the position of the ball after, let's say, falling 108 feet? So once again, to help out here, we can draw a little diagram here. We have our little person here at the top. We're going to throw this ball down. And once again, we still know that the building is still 220 feet. And we want to know here, what is the position after the ball has fallen 108 feet? So that means here the ball has fallen 108 feet. So we can calculate this. We know that the building we said was 220. So if we take 220 minus the 108, we end up with 112 feet. Okay, so that tells us that our position is 112 feet. Now, if I was to ask, at what time will our position be At what time will our position be 112 feet? Well, we have our position formula up here. We know it's a negative 16t squared minus 22t plus 220. So we're going to take our formula, negative 16t squared minus 22t plus 220. And we know we want to set that equal to the 112. So if we solve this, we have negative 16t squared minus 22t plus the 108. Now, to make our calculations easier here, we can simply, everything's even here, so we could simply factor out a negative 2. And if we factor out a negative 2, we're going to be left with 8t squared minus 11t. I'm sorry, whoops, plus 11t. We took out a negative 2, and then we're left with a minus 54. And if we were now to factor this trinomial, how can we factor this? I'm going to try if we have 8t squared, we can think of this as 8t times t. And then to get 54, we could what try 27 and 2. So at this point, it looks like we're going to maybe have a positive 27 and a negative 2. And if we set each one of these equal to 0, 8t plus 27 equals 0, t minus 2 equals 0. And of course, the negative 2, we could divide that away. That's not going to help us out any. So if we set this equal to 0, we're going to end up with t equals a negative 27 over 8, and t equals 2. Now, keep in mind, we're solving for t, and that tells us that our time is a negative 27 over 8 seconds, or time is equal to 2 seconds. And you're probably on the right track here with this position, with this problem dealing with time is not going to be negative, so therefore we can exclude this answer and know that our time must be the 2 seconds. So if we go back up here, we calculated what is the position after falling 108 feet, and we came up with that at what time will our position be 112? So now if we want to calculate the velocity, then we can simply calculate the velocity at this position by taking v and plugging 2 in to the velocity equation. And if you recall, our velocity formula is up here that we calculated, negative 32t minus 22. So a negative 32t minus 22. And if we substitute in the 2 seconds, we end up with an answer of negative 86 feet per second. So that's how we can calculate the velocity. So first here, if we want to find the velocity, I guess I didn't really state broke this down to you in steps here. If you're trying to find the velocity of this ball after 108 feet, then first we need to figure out what is the position And we know that's 112. And then at what time will the position be 112 feet? So here we know after 112 feet, it's going to take 2 seconds to get to that position. And so if we want to calculate the velocity, we simply plug 2 into our velocity formula. So keep in mind here for this example, if you look at the formula for velocity, you know that if we're trying to calculate velocity, we must know the time. So if you don't know the time, you need to come up with a way to calculate the time in order to calculate the velocity. So again, if we quickly review here, the first example was the ball is thrown straight down. And if we want to calculate the velocity after 3 seconds, then you can take the position function, we take the derivative, and that's going to give you the velocity function. And the velocity function here is based on the time t. So for this example, we ended up with the negative 118. The next question we were possessed with here, it says, what is, I guess the question should have been, what is the velocity after falling 108 feet? So the velocity, in order to calculate the velocity, we need to figure out, first of all, what is the position at that time so we can calculate the amount of time. And once we know the amount of time, we can certainly calculate the velocity.